session break. So we have another topic for today, which is on liabilities under Companies Act. And we have our speaker, CSJ Sundharesan, here. So let's welcome him with the floor. Okay, please give a big round of applause. So please come. Here we have with us a life coach guru for direct who will specialize himself in coaching directors and building board strategies. So I just give present before you a small information and a brief profile of today's speaker. He is a company secretary by profession. He is a member of Society of Corporate Compliance and Ethics, USA. He is a Center of Corporate Governance. He is a member of Institute of Directors. He is a member of Association of Secretaries and Managers, Calcutta. He is a Bachelor of General Laws, Annamalai University. He is a Bachelor of Law, Karnataka University. He conducts role play in real life for board members who are in stress and distress, and he assists and trains minority shareholders in resolving issues. He has got more than a decade of experience in coaching all the directors and board on board strategies. He is a principal faculty in Institute of Directors, where he has trained more than 2,500 members in rate and is rated must here. Please give a big round of applause for his achievements. He is a visiting professor at Institute of Management and Technology for Corporate Governance. He is a regular speaker at our institute, company secretary, and many other forums. He has launched an initiative DART, a roundtable for boards and advisors, along with the World Trade Center, Bangalore. He has published a book titled Board Anatomy that brings out the several of governance and compliance and risk. He is a ECG specialist. Presently, he is into practice under the same style of Sundharesan and Associates. His firm specializes in corporate consulting and advisory with core focus on due diligence and corporate compliance. With this brief profile, let's welcome today's dynamic speaker, C.S. Sundharesan Jayamurthy. Please give a big round of applause to today's speaker.
Good morning.
Good morning.
First, let me thank Shira for giving this opportunity and this time when the brochure was getting prepared, so Shivram asked me, which topic would you love to pick up? So I don't know the history of so many presentations that I have done. Liability is one thing which I have not handled in detail. Of course, there have been passing remarks which I have made in many presentations earlier. So today I thought I'll pick this topic called liability. Now I just stopped at that, right? So where am I coming from from a ECG specialist point of view? Why do I call myself an ECG? Very simple. I do three types of things in life, which is training people on ethics, compliance, and governance. So that is ECG, nothing to do with your heart rate. And of course, the logic behind ECG is very simple. If a corporate, the lines are crooked, corporate is dead. Human being, if the line is straight, human being is dead. So that is what is the ECG thing coming from. Now let me pick the question which my friend had, which is, independent directors, not fair enough, how do you expect them to know everything? Many companies will die, many directors will go off. Sorry. The purpose of being a director itself is very simple. Liability is personal. Unless and until you don't check the data that is available in the MCA website on a regular basis, or before or after having taken up directorship, you have checked whether things are right or not, please understand, appreciate, directorship is something which is to do with selfie. It's not a group photo, it's a selfie. The person comes on his own, dies on his own. So this is what I wanted to clarify relating to liability. Now, You know, it's so common, right? I mean, when we talk, most of us talk about liability, actually we don't talk about assets. Company law doesn't throw up assets, right? The other question which came up last session, during the session was, what is the penal provision if I don't comply with CSR? Now, why did we even ask that question? There is a CSR, there is a provision, you are supposed to comply. But look at the human, you know, psychology. Beyond trying to go to the last paragraph of any section and see what will happen if I do not comply.
Sir, let me correct you since you raised that issue. So basically because of not intentional mismanagement in most of the companies. Because I just want to tell you the first point you raised. Most of the companies in the, take an example, smaller companies, it's all managed by chartered accountants, not even by the directors. And they are not even aware of the implications. It's not because intentional shortcomings come in the filings. We are not even aware of the filings. That is the issue. Not because the question is being asked because of that context. Not because of the issue. Not because of the ethical issue.
No. Any question, I am here. 90th minute, if you don't get answers to all these questions, you don't call me again. So I'll give you solutions. You know, all this is not the auditor's problem. It is not a chartered accountant's problem. It is a director's problem only. Okay, we just made a scapegoat out of chartered accountant, right? I mean, I just put up all the slides. It's all not fair. Actually, I have a big slide. But I have given you all the presentations. I mean, what is very important is already circulated to you. So, what I am going to discuss is something general. So, coming back, you know, assets. And now, you know, it's such a sensitive topic, right? All of you know what your asset is. How many of you know what your liability is? Are we getting it? Why? Because asset can be seen. Asset can be felt. Asset can be traded. But liability, nobody trades, right? Would your kitten kin come forward and say, give me all the liabilities as a chartered accountant that you have incurred? I will let you, Yayati story, right? No, it's not possible, right? So nobody wants to touch this animal called liability. Are we getting it? So what is it? An asset is tangible. A liability is intangible. Look at all the entries in the balance sheet. Yeah, please.
Liability also, human defined it as unseen karma.
Karma, yeah. Now you are getting into something different. So, sir, if you can use a mic. Yeah. What is a liability for me may be an asset for some other person. Which is, you bought a home for a housing loan. Now housing loan becomes an asset for, say, HDFC bank, and it is a liability for you.
Yeah.
Right? So that is what, you know, I was just watching yesterday's also session. So Srividya ended her presentation with exercise for class. If I want to start, I would just tell you, take a deep breath. And do, that's all. I mean, I'm not teaching yoga. Just do that. Take a deep breath. And then give it up. Where is the liability?
Relief.
No? That 0.0 second when you took the breath and you stopped, you actually did not know whether you'll be alive or not, right?
Yeah.
You that is a liability. So your breathing in is your asset or life, breathing out is death. In between that, whatever a prana they call, no? You don't know actually.
Thin line.
Right? So that is liability, right? So how do you even look at liability? How do you identify liability? And then you will see in one of my slides I have said, let us reverse liability. Is it possible? Now this, whatever I am talking about, can you reverse it?
Provided, I am aware of what I am looking.
Super. They say reverse your age, correct? They say reverse your diabetes. Age is not visible, diabetes is not visible, but whereas you are all working towards reversing your whatever. So I am telling you, liability which is not visible, let us look at how to reverse it. Look spiritual, right? You will be thinking, what is this man? Companies act is not, and then he is now talking about some reversal and all that. Is it possible? Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. Everything is possible. Don't say, he was shaking his head on the opposite side. So where I'm driving home the point is, today in the next 90 minutes, what we are going to see is, forget it, I am not here to discuss 447, 448. I have done that enough in the last 5 years for our institute. I am going to tell you how we are not going to get into that. Together, it is not like I am some Babaji and all that, wearing some good words, good words and all that, coming in, giving you gyan malum. Let us together try and see if this concept called liability can ever be reversed. Yeah. So, now you understood where we are getting into, right? Okay, so I was thinking of what to name. I have this unique ways of making naming my presentation, you know, like succession planning, Putrabo. Then, any presentation on prevention of sexual harassment act, Agni Pariksha. And don't ask me if I can name it. But this is how I, so for this I was just trying to figure out. The one closest which I got is Aham Brahmasmi. Any idea what does it mean? I am God. Now the moment you start thinking about that, your liability has got triggered. But for this, Midas to Brahmas, what is the story between these two liabilities? Actually, Midas touches for assets, right? Whatever this fellow touched turned into gold. But that became a liability. And the reverse is the story of the other one, which is, the fellow had all the assets, the only liability was how to get killed. And the only way to get him killed was to have this fellow touch his head. And then he went bust. So two concepts are emerging for liabilities, which is, one you call it greed, the other you call it pride, whatever it is. End of the day, these are the two stories which you get connected with a liability. Right? Now, of course, this is my popular one. I will keep giving you a lot of stories, okay, like from a motorbike. Who is motorbike? Mukesh Bhai. Very fondly we call him. So from his story to whatever stories. We'll just keep discussing on how this whole liability issue is going to get reversed. And this is what I believe in, which I picked up from the law school professor. I always do this and I keep repeating it in all my sessions, which is one takeaway for you. Forget 90 minutes. Only one point you take away from this room and implement it on a Monday morning, my job is done. Okay? So here we are, and the question that I keep asking is, what is liability? Anybody, what is liability? Not an asset.
What you owe to others.
What you owe to others. Monetary, non-monetary?
It can be anything.
So monetary becomes tangible. Non-monetary becomes? Are you clear to you here? Okay. Oh my God. Now what is this? Very simple. So when people said liability, how does it get created? Very simple. An intangible liability can get created out of these three stories. If you know of something and you don't speak, there is a liability. If you fail to see something, there is a liability, which is Dhritarashtra story, which is the Bhishma story and all that. And then when you are getting to hear something and you have not reacted, now please understand, there are a zillion stories of chartered accountants in the recent past where somebody would have fumbled up on one of these. So they would have acted one of these monkeys in one of the cases. We'll see. As we go along, we'll see what happened, you know, whether it was PMC, whether it was ILFS, whether whatever, you know. And interesting, I attended something which Shyam Ram Adhyani, I attended about a week back. And the session was very clear. Are auditors liable? Now, he put across so beautifully and said, we give an opinion. Now, if we were not shown what was supposed to be seen, if we were not shown something that we should have seen, how are we? Lovely, no? Typical, a lawyer with a legal tinge. He replied and then he walked out of that particular session. But amazing, this is what happens. Now, where is the liability arising from? Anybody guess? A tangible liability, where does it arise? Have you ever thought about it?
Yes. your position and your acts.
Lovely, you have gone to the next level actually. Sir, these are the two things, sir. What is this?
Pen.
Pen. And then they sell something called a DSC, right? What are these? Your karma is, somebody said, no, law of karma. The karma starts from the first time you use a pen or a DSC. Are you clear? If you don't sign any document, is there any karma? Is there any liability?
No.
See, why I'm telling you this is liability is so funny, right? Capital. Can you see capital? They show some piece of paper and say, this is the share certificate, and then one OYO says, I'm worth $1 billion. Who says so? Maya, right? Liability is a Maya, right? And then suddenly you find Snati, which was valued at $1.1 billion, today is struggling to sell it at 100 million, which is hardly 10% of the valuation. Capital. Reserves in surplus. Have you ever seen it? Can you get to see it?
No, only spelling.
Ha, spelling. And then there is some number there, and then they say they can be issued as bonus share, they can be used to pay. But have you ever seen it? No. Loans and advances. Have you ever seen it? No, you are staring at it. You are chartered accountants. I am not. I am still a student. I have not passed this course actually. So, have you seen it?
Only the balance sheet.
I have a balance sheet also, they are just reflecting, but have you seen it? You are calling it liability? Is it too much? No. Or you are thinking, what is this like? Asset side, you are able to see everything, right? Land and building, yes! Go hug it, love it. Cars. Cash. You are able to see cash, right? Bank balance.
To associate with every liability, that's an asset.
Sir, that's a journal entry, sir.
That's what
I'm saying. I'm talking about real-time situation.
Yeah.
Poor fellows now look at so many people who are struggling, whether it's director, chartered accountant, company secretary, liability, liability, liability. Where does the liability come from? Liability is something you can't even see. But you are booked for liability. Are you ready? Yeah?
Yes.
So, pen and a DSC. Now, where does this come from? I'll tell you. Yesterday, in fact, Srividya, past a passing reference, so see how attentive I was actually. She just said one NCLT case which was there recently for incorporation and she went away. Fortunately, she spent only 30 seconds on that. I am going to spend a good time on that. This is the case that she is referring to, which is Mrs. Swarnalata, correct? Yeah, Swarnalata versus Mrs. Colored Books. You know what happened? Be careful, this pen and a DSC, this is what creates hell in our life actually. No? So, Swarnalata was the wife of some person, X. X incorporated a company called Color Books. Right? Husband, wife, pati, patni, there has to be somebody else now. I am not putting that as chartered account. Okay, let me not get into that. Some professional. What they did, how many debtors you need to incorporate a company?
Two.
Already the husband and wife were fighting, it was a divorce case, and the court was in the matrimony court. What did the husband do? Uploaded data, man. Let's see what happens. Whose data? Swarnalata's data. Correct, no? Signature? First of all, liability because of your signature. Now look at this case, somebody else's signature. Copy, paste, attach.
Upload.
Then CBA downloads. Correct, no, somebody has to upload, somebody has to download. When they found that it was a forgery case. Now look at this, what happened to him? To him, her, whatever. Look at this, this is a judgment. The first one very clearly says, false declaration has been given and it has been testified by a professional. You are not seeing the person, you are, so when my dear friend went into roads, no, he has actually jumped into some intangible liability. Now this is an intangible liability, right? What is it? Not having seen Swarnalata, the professional chose to go ahead and certify the signature.
Sir, what is the case about it? It's a free person. What is the case?
No, I don't know about the divorce case.
What was the case?
This case was filed by Swarnalata. Saying that, without asking my permission, these fellows went and incorporated a company.
Okay, that's
look at the next slide, what is going to happen? Are we clear with this?
Yeah.
So, it is not your signature, it is somebody else's. I call this spirit. Look at the judgment. This is a Bangalore case actually. Look at this. The company which was incorporated, the court said null and void. My God. First time in the history, at least I have not, last 30 years I am in this profession and I have not come across something like this, which is reversal of a COI. Certificate of incorporation gone, finished. Got it? Consequences, got it? So, look at this case, how beautifully it unfolds your liability. One, liability for the husband. Liability for the professional who went ahead and certified whatever they have certified, which should not have been certified. Right? And finally, liability for the company. Poor thing which is not non-living creature, that also died. Great? Now. Now, this is not enough. Your pen drive and DSC may not be enough. I am going to tell you what are the emerging liabilities which is happening. Which is first is, risk of not doing anything. This is like not doing anything, going to a park, sitting outside below a coconut tree. The coconut wanted to fall only on that day on the head.
Destiny, sir.
So even if you don't do anything, today there is a liability. Not any time. Next is this lovely one which is called, all of you would have heard, thank God it's Friday, right? TJR. Now all the board members are saying, thank God it's not Friday. Why? Non-bailable arrest warrant is issued only on a Friday. Saturday, Sunday is a court holiday. So let them come and experience how our Indian jails are. Everybody will not get AC, TV and all that. Please, huh? So this is a problem with TJ here. Next. This is absolute. Which is, suddenly you find the most ethical person makes an unethical decision. What is it? I'll tell you. Make my trip. There was a lady in Chennai who was the best employee in the company, but she did not like something about Narendra Modi. Correct? Something. Not everything. Went online, shot out something on the social media, and the troll that came up was, all the Indians should boycott buying ticket in Make My India. Now what did the company do, man? I mean, they did not even know who this character is, who is sitting some miles away from their registered office in a town, in a city. And this lady just wanted to take something up. Maybe right, maybe wrong. Huh? But the country did not, or the country people did not take it the right way. Trolled. So these are the risks that you are right. So one is your own karta, karma, whatever you call it, you are doing. The other liability is you are not doing anything, but somebody else is doing it for you. So both ways.
Ultimately, it concludes the karma, sir. You do or don't do, it's ultimate karma.
125. I will release the answer to you and then.
Okay.
So quickly giving you examples of this. Look at this. Today with UDIN, say, oh wow! But you know, I don't want to comment on UDIN now. Okay, in UDIN you have two forms, right? One is report, which is when you take a pen and physically sign a document. Correct? That is when I said pen. The second one is on the certifications, which is you certify a form, you are getting into liability. The third one is nothingness, which is, there are a lot of concepts, right? Accountant. A chartered accountant may even be an accountant. Need not be a CFO. Now the CFO delegates the signing powers to the accountant. And and the accountant manifoldly signs this check, which gets bounced. Accountant goes to jail? He goes to jail. Sure.
No, mostly it is approved.
How about he takes somebody along with him?
Yes, sir.
To his company inside everywhere, right? 1 to 10, 10 to 1, single person, how many times will it count? So understood? Check bouncing. Now there is again one upper category which is called directors. So look at how many people you take along for an action of third party. Then of course NBW is what I just told you, and look at how I have connected this again to the three monkeys. Very simple, not doing anything connects to C. That is, you see something, like you see a lot of these videos which come up, you know, somebody struggling on the after an accident and people are busy taking selfies, right? So C. And then indulgence in regulation is here, because always a policeman comes and knocks your door and says, sir, non-bailable warrant. You know, nobody serves it. It's like they serve it. And the third one is free doom of speech. Not freedom of speech. Free doom. So you go to a public domain and then do something. You may do, you may not do. Now, you may do. Very simple. Our Tesla, the CEO of Tesla, right? Yeah, so he goes, makes some funny statement, and then he withdraws the statement, says I'm sorry, but by the time the stock prices have crashed about few million dollars. So understand, these are all the karmas, these are all the liabilities which actually get built in. So it's not that you have to do some, but all these underlying thing is action. Only one thing, you have to do some action to get into a liability. Now, this is my favorite story. Who is this? Okay, why? Amazing. What is it that he said? In 18 months, Reliance will become a zero debt company. Zero debt is equal to zero liability? No. Chappi. Is zero debt a zero liability?
Nobody said debt.
He just said liability is when you owe something. So that's what your definition is, right? So when you don't owe anybody anything, there is no liability. Confusing, sir. That's all. So I also imagine when you are hearing me, you get confused. This presentation when I was preparing, what I would have gone through. Right? Let's crack it step by step. Now, what is this guy trying to do? There was issue saying that it's a $1 billion borrowing, and then shareholders were unhappy and all that. So this annual general meeting, he went public and he very beautifully put across that from a $65 billion liability, $65 billion, not rupees, $65 billion, I don't know if my calculator can even take that amount, you know. From a $19 billion in financial year 2015, he's going to bring it to zero. Amazing. So, in the process, what they are going to do is they are going to sell. Sell what? Assets. Sell the liability. Sir, what is he selling? Shares. Shares, which is the side? Liability. So, it's so funny, right? To. Why? Is it not sounding proper? Correct, no. When an Aam Aadmi has to erase the liability, he has to sell the asset. See, when the richest Indian has to sell the liability, become make it zero, he sells another liability.
He's selling all assets, sir. Because they hold his shares now.
That is what, sir. One's liability is other man's asset.
Correct.
He's selling our assets.
Yeah, assets, sir.
So that is what our brilliant merchant said. So wait. So concept wise, are you agreeing?
Yes.
That he is selling a liability,
yeah,
to erase a liability.
Yes.
What does a Saudi company get? Shares and paper. What is it? Paper.
Tradable paper.
Okay, tradable paper. Which is, they have put a value to that paper. So long as there is a value.
Till fraud is found.
Sir. That section separate. Okay. So understood the concept. So an asset is not required to zero a liability. A liability is required to zero a liability. I'm teaching you everything possible wrong in accounting.
No, I'm not.
So my question to you is this.
No CA student is sitting here, sir. That is the one good thing.
Experience.
No, otherwise you will go and write wrong thing in the exam.
Fortunately, you will not be writing the director exam, hopefully. So we are safe. So my question is, will Reliance become a zero liability company? Question mark. Will Mukesh Ambani become a zero liability person? Question mark. We'll see. We'll get into the answers, okay? Is it possible to reverse the liability? Till now, are you confident? You're with me? That you can reverse your liability? Anybody can do that, right? Why? Nobody is shaking here.
Yes,
sir.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Transfer from one place to another, sir. Liability.
I don't know.
That's what happens.
Today you are all proud that you have a house, but that house has got 70% of bank loan. Are you happy or unhappy staying in the house? You are unhappy, rest of the people are happy. See, asset, the problem is that, no, asset you will never enjoy. Everybody around you will enjoy. Liability only you will enjoy. Proceed. Okay, so now what are we going to go through? Very simple. I always try and do this, okay? Yantra, mantra, tantra. No, magician, nothing. Okay? But end of the day, I want you to know there are three things which exist in this world. Which is your entry. Entry into the world. And from 0 to 20 years, you are only doing mole searching. What is mole searching? Identity crisis. Because you don't know why you were born. Somebody tells you why you have to be born and what you have to be.
Give it a name also.
And 21st year you fail on everything. Means you don't become what you are supposed to become, then you go for whole searching. No, whole, that's why I put very clearly. Yeah? If you don't know anything, then you carry a stick and walk on a golf course searching for 18 holes. That's also whole searching. Whole character. Now, okay, let me at least mold my character. Next 20 years you spend on character building. Clear? And the last 20 years you spend on, that's when the liability is at its peak. That's when you turn to the conscience and then try to do something.
Also.
So in the sense of entry, which is called I am who, my last slide also will end with this. Arrogance of existence. Suddenly you change that beautiful Ramana Maharshi thing to who I am. Arrogance. And after you give up everything, you ask a question that you should have asked at when you are 5 years old. Why do you have to ask at 60 years and everything is gone and then say, who am I? Do some soul searching.
Sir, you need experience to ask that question. That's right.
That 60 years.
60 minutes. You need experience.
60 minutes. Stay with me and you will ask this question. You don't need 60 years. Okay. So no liability means more inner intelligence. So that is where I'm telling you why somebody says I've renounced the world, they have gone, and then they are very happy, they don't have anything to lose. The biggest fear today is losing. So that is what is liability. So three things that we'll discuss and we'll close with how to reverse this liability is I am who, what is liability? Who I am is who is liable for this liability, and finally, why does the liability at all arise? Is the last stage of your system, which is who am I? This is how we do. Sad news, but hot news. So Uday Kotak came up with this, saying that chartered accountants are the weakest link of governments. No. He went ahead and issued perpetual debentures to protect his company, and I don't know why somebody is writing a code for us. Okay. So there's a lot of this gimmick. So what is real you don't get to see. But it's easy to comment somebody saying that somebody has not done a job. See, please understand, there are two things that will haunt you forever, which even the regulators are haunting you, which is business has to be done in anybody? Business has to be done in letter and what is it? What is spirit?
That's
one spirit. No, I'm just asking, what is spirit?
You should be doing the business that you have to do.
Sir.
That's simple as that.
Sir, spirit, sir.
Sir, if you tell something, it is reflective of what you're thinking, sir. Spirit means introspection. Are you doing your dharma correctly or not? Conscience, sir. Conscience. Are you in the right business? For example, if you're going to make transformers, are you making transformers or are you doing some other shaking things?
That is letter, sir.
Letter, sir. But are you controlling that letter?
Are you making transformers with water?
Exactly.
Spirit, sir.
Sir, you can do a lot of wordplay, sir.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, there is something called truth and conscience within. You cannot escape that. You can hide away so many things by doing word, what you call jargons and other things, and doing a lot of gimmicks. At the end of the day, you have to answer yourself. Am I doing what I am supposed to do? As a brother, am I speaking the truth? Am I in this business? Am I giving value to my shareholders? Am I giving value to my creditors? Am I giving value to other stakeholders? Have I done 100%? Yes or no? If something within is a little bit shaky, then kindly know that your foundation is collapsed. That's it.
Okay, I will rest your case at that. But at 125, when I'm going to put that slide, you will realize why I'm telling you spirit is very dangerous.
Okay, sir, we'll come to that, sir.
Yeah? So letter is letter, spirit is spirit. Spirit is real? Spirit is real? Letter is real.
Okay.
I can touch, I can feel, I can...
Sir, the fact that you are talking, is it the letter or is it the spirit? Please tell me that. Give me the answer. Is it the spirit that is talking or is it the letter that is talking? Can you give me the answer to that and I will accept what I'm saying.
Again, I'll reserve that, okay? I don't want to go inner searching as of now because we still have a lot of time. So, towards the end, I will tell you. PwC resigns. Now, you saw all these things flashing spot. Spot exchange scam and then PMC scam and so on and so forth. Everywhere it said auditor, auditor, and then in some place it was CFO, whatever. So, either there was a connivance, there was no connivance, there was... all these things are subjective, I'm not getting into the details. But these many cases in the last few... maybe a year, is a little too damaging. That's why we are here to understand what this whole liability which you are talking, you know, it's not about Companies Act and all that, it's beyond Companies Act actually on the liability front because it can hit you from anywhere, anytime, any soon. Okay? So, again, coming to this question, that's a lovely one which you gave the answer, and this is what is the meaning, dictionary meaning, which is a fancy word for debt, which is what Reliance, I told you, Ambani. Zero debt is liability, zero liability. As per the definition, it says yes. If a person has got zero debt, that person has got no liability is what people think, but that's a tangible form of looking at things. Or something that you owe. Now, in financial parlance, it says liability is defined as future sacrifices of economic benefits and all that, because is there in print? This is what is liability. Now, asset. Look at the definition of asset. It's so beautiful. Any asset is any resource owned by the business. Right? Now, here again, what is share capital? What is share? It's owned. It's owned, right? But it is appearing a liability. It is supposed to be an asset which is actually coming in liability, and that is why Ambani could trade it. So the only entry which you really find which is a owned thing is a capital which he has traded off. Now, types of assets and liabilities very simple. We have tangible and intangible. Now, what I am going to take you through is this. Can you have an answer for this? Which is, can there be a tangible asset with liability? The second question is, can there be a tangible asset without liability? Can we answer the first one? With liability? Yes. Example? He said, now loan. To buy a house, you take a loan, it becomes a asset with liability. You bought a house with cash, your own self-generated cash, is there a liability? No, that's okay, but is there a liability? So, tangible asset is asset without liabilities and all cash deal, which Ambani is doing with the Saudi guys, right? The second guy is the Adani guys, where there are a lot of assets, but every asset is backed with a liability. Are we clear? So I'm just trying to do a trade-off between the asset and the liability. Now all cash deal and loan transaction. Now understand, tangible liability without asset, tangible liability with asset, intangible liability with asset. Any example? Can that be intangible? I'll just take you through now. Yeah. Can that be an intangible liability with asset?
No, the only thing I'm showing is third party guarantee.
Contained
liability. Say some, I do some transfer, I violate a transfer, I do it, that liability gets triggered off. Can only think of such cases at this point of time.
What about your brand?
Goodwill.
Your own brand? PwC brand, Deloitte brand, your brand, whatever brand. It is all intangible asset with liability. Correct? With liability. You built it, right? You put in money. So your share capital is standing on one side in your firm and on the other side is the brand, your firm name. So when you want to sell your business, what do you sell? The brand. Along with the business. And what is the other one? Tangible liability, sorry, intangible asset without liability, there's only one thing. Any example? Reputation. So we are discussing four things out here. One is cash, another is loan, another is brand, and the fourth one is the reputation. Now, when you don't do anything and something goes wrong, what do you lose? Reputation. Everything is gone. So, whichever way you look at it, there is a liability while you are doing business, while you are earning. So, this is what I was just telling Infosys, which is reputation and goodwill or brand. Now, in the year 2022, when Saudi deal happens, on the left hand side of the balance sheet of Reliance, what will be there?
Capital.
Yeah.
Capital.
That's all. Yeah. There will be no other entry on the, forget all the small ones, you know, sign, credit card, you know. The big ticket which is going to be there is the capital. Now here again, look at this. It is called net worth or owner's equity. So the point that I was trying to drive is, what did this guy trade off to sell and make this company a zero liability company? So this is what it is as far as cash is concerned. Now from your perspective, start thinking. Each one of you has assets, each one of you have liabilities. Now asset can be, you know, tangible, intangible, liability can be tangible, intangible. Then tangible is something which is visible, intangible is invisible, and both have valuation and value. This is what we have seen as of now. Clear? So the first leg of the presentation is over. I am who? So I am who means? Who are you? Now when I just tried to do something in Companies Act, I found so many you. Not one, huh? So many you. Which is starting from an accountant to a CFO to a finance director to a statutory auditor, cost auditor, internal auditor, you know, there are concurrent auditors. I mean, you know, you have a zillion designations behind you as far as a professional is concerned. Do you agree that the liability is different for each of these? Again, I go back. Huh? You agree? Each one of these characters' liability is different? Yeah. So, when does the liability arise for a professional? This is what we saw in the first beginning. This is basically when there is an action. So, this is sum and substance of whatever. Now, action is the signature of life. It's a very important statement. What is a tangible asset? Now, residential as building in Sadashi Nagar. Wow. Dream. I'm just putting a wish list. A mark. All these are tangibles, right? Which you have identified and which you have wanted. Now, intangible asset is your brand and reputation. Now, let's see how to cover you for this particular phase of your system. When does an intangible liability arise? Anybody? When does die is very simple, right? Intangible. I'm not talking about tangible. Now tangible, you know. When you sign a document, when you put your DSC, when you know all those are tangible liabilities, because the moment you put that, there is a provision under any of the acts which says this is your penalty. So when you can identify the penalty, that becomes your liability. And God alone knows zillion forms would have signed it. And if I have to quantify what my tangible liability is, it must be running into few crores, upwards of 5 crores. When does an intangible law? This is a lovely one. Please understand this. There are two things that can get you into intangible liability. One is knowing, another is knowledge. This is what it said in the three monkey story, right? When you see and don't do something, when you hear and don't do, so that don't do something. Knowing. Now when you talk about knowing, there is something called a conscious disregard. Now look at this. PMC scam. Any idea? Very sad actually, but two stories. This character was a common director in both the companies. I'm talking about PMC Bank and HDIL, which is the infrastructure company. Okay? Now all the loans were given during his time, and 7,000 crores at one point of time was the outstanding of PMC, which was given to HDIL. 6,500 crores was a contract that was supposed to be signed off with the state government by HDIL. Now look at the chain effect. 6,500 crores went, 7,000 crores went. That's all. Over. That 7,000 crores was equal to around 70% of PMC, and PMC is gone. Single exposure to a particular client. Clear? That is called conscious disregard. That is knowing very well that this is going to backfire. Someday you keep pumping. Willful blindness. Now this is another amazing story. I love this. No? In fact,
in the PMC case, there was a system deficiency because RBI does not have sufficient oversight for cooperative banks. So
there
was, it was waiting to happen all these years. So I would not say that it happened overnight, and suddenly all the regulators are very much aware that a cooperative bank is the weakest link in the banking system and has got very poor regulation.
Okay.
So this is waiting to happen.
So who is this in?
So see, this is only the...
Wait, regulator is a link, it's a dotted line. But this, what I'm saying, he's a character who is existing in your realm.
I hold even the regulator liable for this.
See,
RBI is liable for this because they are allowing it to happen and the public are suffering. Very simple.
There was a Varyam Singh, there was a board, there was a auditor, then there was a regulator. See, understand, we are looking at the chain. But here I'm telling you, the first look of this entire case, it's like some thriller, right? Murder. I mean, I would straight away as a guy, right, who did that, knowing very well that this is what is going to happen and knowing very well that this is going to pass. So, why I'm telling you, chartered accountant resigned or chartered accountant did. Now, even before it went to the chartered accountant, who knew? I'm trying to protect a person, right? I mean, if I were your counsel, I'm trying to tell you. First level, there was an individual. Second level, there was a board. And why me? Right? I mean, you can always ask. Then willful blindness, another one. You know, the Deloitte or whoever, you know. But after this bank, now please understand. Who were the parties to this willful blindness? Which means, last 12 years, they knew that here is a company which is waiting to die. Going by what you are saying, RBNU, EDU, MCNU, everybody, because my document is there in the public domain. Who is the primary cause? The board? 100%. Right? I mean, so imagine, I mean, please understand, every proposal goes through the board first. You as an auditor comes to know only during the year. Now, am I right or wrong? Do they ask the auditor everything before disbursement? No.
No.
Correct or no?
When I am
ex-IOP
and board, what happens in the
IOP
space? There's only one person who takes That's what
happened. Correct. So, IL is one sad case in corporate history which I call Nirbhaya. Nirbhaya of the corporate India Inc. Is IL because
1999-2000, there was a saying in the corporate circle, IL is stronger than RBI. And secondly, there was a problem. So suppose you have a sent from IL, you will not get your debit salary in India in the country because so Pandachuk salary has been paid 1999-2000. That was a thing in IL. And it was stronger to take that time also because it is stronger than RBI.
They not only paid salary to employees, they bought tickets. For a football match, the rating agencies. So there are a lot of other things which happen. But willful blindness means what?
Yes.
Knowing very well that this is not the workable proposition or whatever. See, after the scam, everybody says, oh, you should have done it like this. It's like, the cricket. After getting out, a zillion people can say this is not the way you should have batted. But corporate is not like that. You're playing with somebody else's money. The deliberate ignorance. This is another very sad case. You know what happened in ICIC, which is knowing that there is a conflict, you went and fell for a conflict. So understand this concept of knowing is you know that something is going to happen, but you never took any. That is why liability is staring at you from whatever side and you can't escape. The next one is knowledge. No, knowledge is a very, English is a very funny language actually, This knowledge, when I try to do a dictionary meaning, look at what all it throws. Knowledge. The moment you get some paper, it's called knowledge, information. The moment you start opening it, it's called awareness. The moment you start reading it, it's called understanding. So, whichever ways it is, liability you cannot escape from two things, which is called knowing and knowledge. Clear? Now this is another lovely one. Tujhko, lovely song was there. This Govinda song. Main to raste se ja raha tha, Tujhko mirchi lage to, main kya karu? No, this is not that song. This is mirchi money. You know what is mirchi money? Not hot money. Iqbal mirchi is money. Who is Iqbal mirchi? Dawud's. Correct. Now why did you not know the color of money? Look where liability comes. Somebody gave you money and you took the money. Not knowing that it is Mirchi money, it is Dawud money, it is XYZ money. Who all got caught in this Mirchi money? Look at this. There is a Praful Patel, poor guy. He was developing some real estate stuff and the land which was bought apparently belonged to one of Mirchi's wife, and that was bought and they developed it. Raj Kundra. If he was on his own, he would not have been so famous. Unfortunately, he is the husband of Shilpa Shetty, so he got a lot of limelight saying that this fellow also is part of Mirchi money. And then there are two other names which we don't know. And worst thing, look at this. The scam which happened, DHFL. Look at the exposure. DHFL is Dewan Housing Finance Limited. So now you understand where the money is going. So it's all round tripping. In some place or the other. So, when does a tangible liability arise? When does it arise? A tangible liability. Very simple, we just discussed this on briefly and I told you, which is he just started. Tangible liability means what you can see. So, what all you pay? The moment you accept a CFO's position, liability has started ticking.
Yes.
Correct? If you have accepted the CFO position, you have to play that responsibly, which is responsibility kicks in. Now, next is the rights as a CFO you should know, duties as a CFO you should know, process, which is every paper that gets processed in your system you should know, power. You have to exercise your power properly. Now, if you fail in all this, automatically the liability has kicked in. So, this is what I call R cubed DP squared L. For you to remember very easily, it's a chemistry, it's something to do with numbers. R cube means rights, roles, responsibilities, duties, process, power, and finally it ends with life. Clear? So your tangible liability can arise only out of this. Intangible liability is for not doing any of this. Are we clear? Which means I am not a CFO, or I am not a CFO who was supposed to do this, but still I got into a problem. What is that? That's an intangible liability. Yeah. So look at this, very simple. So for the sake of putting this, you know, Companies Act, because the title was Liability under Companies Act, so somewhere in the section should appear. Books of account, very simple. Read only things which are in red. Where the whole-time director in charge of finance, CFO or any other person of the company charged by the board with the duty of complying has not complied. So what is a tangible liability? What you have been named in a legislation is a tangible liability. Next is deposit. If you have taken deposit and not disclosed, annual return. I am not running over all this because you have the presentation. Yeah, so this is another funny one, huh? Be careful, 137. Okay, I am not here to scare you. Already I am scared you. Today is the last day for filing AOC 4. Yeah. When was the last date actually? 29th September. So between 29 September to 30th November, what is happening to you? Liability is there or not? This is only education process. You should have filed it before 29th of September. Suddenly the government came and said, I'll give you extension. Some extension. What is that extension for? Only filing fees I will not charge you. Penalty? This one? I don't know. I'm just leaving this as a thought for you. Think. So don't get carried away with this extension. Extension, you think you are saving around 500 rupees. But what you may be losing is 500 rupees. May. I'm not saying is. I'm not saying shall. May.
So, don't
care about.
Because next year,
we're
still filing within the 2 days.
That is, the software in MCA has got recalibrated not to accept extra fee from you. Has the section got amended? Okay, now. So this is another lovely. 2 days back, Modi had come out with some nice one. Rights without duties can create imbalance. Wow. That is just one line which I picked. And I converted that whole thing into a single point PPT. Now look at what can create imbalance. Roles without responsibility, rights without duty, power without liabilities, exit without a process. Now, exit without a process is so important for a director. Please understand. You have not exited unless the process is completed. That is how important it is from a director point of view. Now, just in the morning, Pranav just discussed on the auditor's exit. Very important. There is only resignation on removal. There is no third way of looking at exit for an audit. So, understand. So everything has to be with the process. If it's without process, it creates an imbalance. Now, liability tools, root cause. So we have discussed this, so I'm not going over this, which is physical and DSC. This is just a recap. These are the things that were on the liability. Now, whom are you liable to? Look at this. Whom are you liable to? Now, from discussing body, spirit, mind and all that, I move to real-time, real-life situation for a CA, which is inside a corporate. Who are you? You are liable to the stakeholder. Very important. So I'll pick only three, which are in red. Personal liability, vicarious liability, and stakeholder liability. Now, what are these three? Let's go to personal liability. Forget, we'll go by the words. Now, what is personal liability? Very simple. The moment you use the pen or the DSC, it is a personal liability. Personal. Vicarious liability. I left my DSC behind in the office, somebody used it. Are you liable? This happens to many directors actually. Where is your DSC?
Sir, the
health sector, where I have managed
800
DSCs. No, that is for selling.
No, no, no.
Only
for
banking. Record. So, that is for selling. That is practical.
It's a practical.
But why you? So, let me ask you this question. As a chartered accountant firm or a company secretary's firm, why should I be holding on to an external fellow's DSC?
You should not be.
It's a, at least today you understood it's a huge liability which is there.
It's a mistake.
Because anything can happen, please understand. Right from the first case, NCLT case which I discussed, to any other case, somebody can pick it up from your office and do you harm. Please be careful. And the third one is a very funny one, which is stakeholder. Today, please understand, this is another concept which I'm working on some other time. It's called extended enterprise. What is called an extended enterprise? Anybody? No longer is, if some of you are working in company, please understand, your desk, your registered office is not the only liability point. The world has moved to a concept called extended enterprise. What is it? Anybody, one example? Work from home.
Virtual
also. Now, suppose a lady or a male member chooses to work from home. What is the office?
Home.
So, registered office plus the home address of, say, one Mughal. That also is your office?
Yes.
If out of 1 lakh employees, 10,000 employees choose to work from home, how many offices do you have? I am only here to bring out a lot of these things which are happening today, which we are another liability. All of us want to hear some Companies Act, FEMA, some stupid legislation. That's all there, man. It's all written. That is known. I am trying to tell you something which is unknown. No, I have not done Third Eye Awakening from Nityananda and all that. So I can't read it beyond you and all that. But I am trying to tell you extended enterprises. Think about it. What is extended enterprises? Today, IT companies allow every employee to go and work anywhere. So, one fellow goes to the park, opens a laptop, starts working. One stray dog comes and bites him. Whose liability is it? Serious, whose liability? Your liability, sir. I'm getting the point. The moment the laptop is open and the person has logged in, the park becomes the workplace for your company. So 10,000 homes plus registered office plus one park, covered park. Think, that is what is stakeholders. Please understand, because today we all think liability to be a very narrow term. No, liability has become a huge term. No longer is it 5 lakh rupees, 2 lakh rupees, 10,000 rupees, which is written in law. It is something which is beyond law. So he said, spirit, think. That is spirit, sir. Beyond law, what comes and hits you is what is spirit. You call it a ghost, you call it a shadow, you call it matama, whatever. But please understand, right? I've just given you a trailer of what can be your extended enterprise. I can go on and on, but you know, like vendors, all the stakeholders, you have an issue at you. A security guard, for example, who's standing at your office. Who is this person? He is your liability, sir. You cannot say it is G4S liability. So long as he is standing at your building, at your premises, you have to protect him. Yeah? Yeah. So let's get into the tangible form. Very simple. You have all this, right? So why I asked you this question is, if you have filed it before 29 September, fee. If you file it today, additional fee. If you file it tomorrow,
penalty.
Right? But there is something called fine. So penalty and fine are the same. Which has lesser liability?
Fine.
Hold up your answer. I have a slide for you. So he says, fine, it's a lesser liability, let's see what it is. Then you have all this. Now, okay, let's come to it later. So between penalty and fine, when that the slide comes, I'll skip. You should always choose penalty. Okay? Fine is a court process. Because the moment you appear before an economic offences court or whatever, they levy a fine. You can go to Mayor Hall Magistrate Court, they may just levy a fine of 5,000 rupees as against 5 lakh rupees, which may be penalty. Don't come back happy. Because when you are filling the passport application next time, your hands will start trembling. There is a thing, have you been convicted? What is the answer? Yes. Have you paid fine? Yes. Avoid it. Yeah, that's what I said. No? So my at 125, I'll release you from Mukti. I'll give you all this Mukti from all these liabilities now. Okay, intangible liability actions. Now, so we are clear. Tangible is very clear. You always checked off things which are laid out in the law, and then you have protection, and then you can roll over. You can go.
Go back to the previous slide. The last section, 50% is only for OPC.
That is because Dashara and Diwali came and by mistake I just. No, that's serious. So OPC is 1% company.
And then small companies also. Huh.
Correct. So, both. You get a 50% discount. I don't know if you will catch that discount. Discount, but typical we are. Yeah, that strikes the eye actually. Maybe. I should have painted it in red.
Discount.
Yeah. So, Anushan, 50% discount for a OPC or a small company on only certain sections. And don't think that the entire Companies Act is free. Okay, intangible liability actions. Now, look at this. Let me see. Intangible. Now you are clear, right? I spoken so much on tangible, intangible, tangible, intangible. Now, intangible is something which is not visible. Why did the government put this? Please read only the head. The rest is all in your file. You can read later. What is it? Auditor has reasons to believe that an offence. Whatever. Rest is. What is the meaning of reasons to believe? Is it not spirit? Is it letter? Sir?
Reasons
to believe. Is it letter?
No, sir. Reasons should be based on facts. Facts is something tangible, right? Facts based on document. If you go deep to the next level, reasons cannot be there without facts. Facts cannot be there without documents and other evidences. So it emanates from the facts.
Good.
So, without documents for others.
Yeah, can you please repeat it?
The reasons has to come from facts and observations. Facts and observations emanate from documents or other source of information. So, the intangible thing has to arise from the tangible thing.
Intangible has to?
Arise from a tangible thing.
Wait. Okay, one second, just hold on. Now, you're doing the audit. You can keep the this thing. So, you're doing the audit. You're in the pantry. You are sitting with the accountant. Accountant comes and tells you something in your ear. Sir, you know what? This is what is happening in the company, sir. Now what happens?
So, I mean, we have to verify the facts, right? I mean, he may not got promotions. Could be any reason. He may be angry with the management. Without verifying the facts, we can't come to a conclusion, right?
Why does Mrs. Breuer exist, sir? Mrs. Breuer is?
Something which I did not want to speak today, actually, unnecessarily got this.
Because you are saying business to believe, I believe that a whistleblower comes to me, because as he said, it's a whistleblower case. What happens then? It is, he comes and gives you some information, he is not going to
be able to verify the facts.
One second, sir, I have to ask the question, you are asking me the question.
So you are better informed, I am asking you that question.
This is same side of my life, actually. You got his question, so I think if you can speak into the mic, it's good because so many people sitting in the back actually. If you can repeat that, please, for me. Whistleblower, yeah, that part, because I don't know if everybody got that. And I'm going to tell you what. Huh?
Sir, I just, because from your discussions, I'm beginning to get a lot of doubts now. Just a second, sir. Let me tell you one thing. When you say reasons to believe, now a case came to my mind just now saying that there is some sort of a whistleblower information. It is not backed by facts. which is not backed by fact, but the proceeding is pending before the audit committee.
Wait, don't go there, na. I just told you in the pantry, one good accountant came and told you, because you know he has seen you as a partner in the firm, so he said, let's go for chai pe charcha, coffee. He takes you and then he speaks. He speaks his heart out. What do you do? Reasons to believe?
Sir,
I am in no hurry, sir. Take your time.
Sir, one thing I would just like to add here. The reasons to believe, there are two things there. One is fact, another is fiction. Now, what do you believe? Do you believe the facts or do you believe the fiction?
Okay, it's okay. Let's do a juggle one. The moment that person has told you, will you take action or not? Let's go. That's the intangible, right?
I will take my time, I will evaluate using my professional skepticism.
Okay.
I will try to ascertain. I will try to ascertain through my known sources. Because I am not Nityananda. I will try to ascertain it through some evidence before me, whether it is true or I will try to come to my own informed conclusion in a deliberate and slow manner. I will not be hasty in judgment.
So you will say me. You are me. And we will start.
I will start off slowly. I will just go step by step to ascertain it.
Wait. So where I want to take you through is, you just brought out a concept called the whistleblower. Now you also have to say, that's why I gave you, I found it very interesting, that's why I gave you the, So what do you say about whistleblower?
Sir, whistleblower,
he is a whistleblower. The accountant is a whistleblower, what is his good name?
Lakshmi Narayan.
He is just confessed to Lakshmi Narayan saying that this is what is happening. Will you take action or not?
I am supposed to take action.
Good. Stop. So, please understand that reasons to believe can also come from concepts called a whistleblower. Do I need to name the company now? So, other point which Lakshman said is, the employee may not have been given a salary hike, show this fellow is coming and telling me. It's a benefit of doubt, whatever. You know, somebody said that, no? So that I'm not getting into. You are supposed to do this, which is, if an auditor has reasons to believe that an offense involving fraud, which means your investigation starts. Wait, starts. When would you report? Now he said, after finding out the facts, if there is a consequence, and if in the consequence, of course, very unfortunate that a fraud has been quantified under company law, Companies Act. So if that breach, that threshold limit is reached, I will go and report, right? So this is called reporting, and this is not a letter. This is, can be hearsay, it can be seen, anything, right? So that is why I put this under intangible. Now there is a concept this. So what I have told you is not what I have got. Are you seeing it clearly? This is what a SEBI LODR tells you, which is, listed company shall follow its obligations in letter and spirit. Who says so? The regulator says so. I have not said. Right? Now, here is where the catch is. I know what is there in letter. How do I know what is there in the spirit? Yeah, that also I may know otherwise. But inside the company, how will I know? Right? So this is where the catch is. And one fellow who has done it beautifully is, of course, Malaya. No? Manufactured spirit, supplied spirit, sold spirit, made money in spirit, got Gandhi's money in spirit and made a spirited exit. Everything in spirit, so he followed the LODR guidelines to the... And the other fellow who followed spirit is Ramlinga Raju. What is spirit? Ghost employee, ghost invoice, ghost turnover, ghost fixed deposit, ghost. So he also. So from 2009 to 2019, two entrepreneurs who have used this word spirit in the literal meaning are Ramlinga Raju and Bali. So my takeaway for you is, business is always done in letter, never in spirit. I will justify this, please don't bounce on me, please hold on. Yeah. So why am I saying spirit? Please understand, as professionals you have to be so careful. How many cases I see? In a big hurry to incorporate the company, you lend your name as a director. Who asked you to do that? Sir, did I ask you to do that?
Yes.
One fine day, you are not able to come out of the company. What is this? why did you do this? What is this? This is not a tangible liability. This becomes your intangible liability. A liability which you can never cure. Second, registered office address. My God, please be careful. I always tell you cautionary tales, huh? So I'm like the Mahabharata. Registered office. Somebody went and put one post in front of the, they thought that, you know, it's a photo session actually, that 22 days. So whoever the chartered accountant or company secretaries, they went and posed and then did all this nice modeling and all that they did and it uploaded. Now whose photograph is there in the website? How do you get out of this office problem? Why did you give your office as a registered office? Did I ask you to remember? Intangible liability. Right? Next, oh my God, this is another difficult one. One GST officer is going somewhere and your office is a registered office for a private company and then you have not put the GST number. Yesterday, Shivudya just announced a penalty, 50,000 rupees. For what? The office is not yours, GST is not yours, and you have not displayed. For that, you are going to pay 50,000 rupees. Right? Careful. Subscriber. This is the next brilliant one. Again, taking a cue from yesterday's presentation. Name lend. Why did you lend your name? In fact, in one company which was long back incorporated by a CFO, one of the partners died in. Now that partner shares, they are finding it such a big difficulty to transfer it to the multinational company again. See, certain things understand. Do it. But learn to exit from it. If you have lent your name, if you have lent your directorship, exit in 1 month's time. It's not worth holding that baby for whatever reason because it's not your baby. Are we clear? These are all intangible liability which is staring at you. Certifying a form without evidence. Now that is what is the case I discussed when I started and that is the relevant case law which is Nagarpan Swarnalata versus Color Book Associates, you can just Google and you'll get it. So, if you are given the registered office, now look at this. Every officer who is in default, now who is it? You are the director, you are the subscriber, it is your office. But it is not your company. Clear? This is all practical scenario which can come and stir it. Chartered, this is a memorandum and articles, it requires amendment, that of course passing remark. Subscription money again is an issue. Please ensure that it comes from your account, it hits that account because otherwise everybody is liable for a penalty. And NCLT, look at the verdict that was given in that Swarnalata case. The finding was section 71B, but look at the second one. Providing false information or suppressing any information shall be liable for action under 440A. The fees that you have got for incorporation may be 20,000, 50,000, 1 lakh. But just read section 448. Is it worth all that trouble? Question mark. Okay, now we move on to the second level of discussion, which is who I am, which is the arrogance level, which is each of you think that because you are holding this position, this is what you are. So I am not getting into again. The PPT covers all these definitions, so I'll just remove the definitions. But what you need to understand is, there is a character called officer. There is a character called officer in default. There is somebody called a KMP, statutory auditor, and only these five characters, that is, you may be 20 types of professional persons inside the company, but all of you get bundled into five categories. That's it. Are you getting it? Cost auditor, internal auditor, whatever. You may say companies are, does not have 138, there is no liability for cost, for internal auditor. But you are an officer of a company. And every section in companies act uses the word officer. So who is an officer? Very simple. This is what is a huge laundry list of who they are. I am not getting into it. Now the interesting part we'll discuss, that is what it is. Now look at this. Officer in default. If you are a CFO and if you have filed DIR 12, your meter starts. It's like a Chennai odometer, right? The meter starts. If you are a CFO, you are not filing the form DIR-12. No, Robert. If you are a CFO, you have not filed a form DIR-12, is there an issue or not? Tangible, intangible? Intangible. If you file DIR-12, tangible. Are you getting the theory clear? So, you are lending out your position as a CFO, but you are not statutorily appointed as a KMP. So you are outside that blue mark. Now, any person means what? Now look, this is where I am putting the officer. As an accountant, are you liable?
Yes.
A person who was instrumental in preparing the documents, he is liable. The next one, senior management, which is anybody who is advising the board. Are you liable? Yes. Section 178 is what says, what is a senior manager? Clear? So whichever category you are, this is why I say, who I am. In fact, below that I put some nice argument. First, the person will ask, who I am. Then, in doubt, they'll ask, who my father is. So typical answer in every movie, if you don't know who your father is, you know, what can you know? That is where you will land up. So anybody who is getting prosecuted first time, do you know who I am? Does ROC bother? Does the system bother? Today we are getting into an AI world, artificial intelligence. Now the computer doesn't want to know who you are. Maybe the current ROC will know how big you are, who you are, whose son you are and all that. The computer doesn't understand you. Straight away, one day delay. Tomorrow if you file, 50,000 rupees is your penalty. And nobody is going to come and serve at your office. It just gets generated. That is what is the power of artificial intelligence. Okay. Now look at this. He is officer of the company who is in default and officer who is in default. Are they same? Answer is no. Please understand, this is a very, very tricky stuff. Officer who is in default will include the officer. But doesn't work the other way around. So not that every officer is an officer in default, but every officer in default is an officer. Okay, now, liability, yeah. Now look at the liabilities, very simple, it is there in your presentation, which is 138, no liability. 148, very less liability for a cost auditor actually, but except for 448, where they have said cost auditor, secretary auditor, statutory auditor, all the three fellows will fall under the purview of that false statement. Nowhere else has there been a liability mentioned for. This is a valuation. Emerging field, emerging business, but be careful, this is what is a liability for a valuation professional. Now, for a practicing chartered accountant, appearance before an authorized representative, authorized as an authorized representative, very important. Please be careful, no outsourcing. In case there's any misrepresentation, contempt. Certification. Yesterday, I think there was a full session on certification. I'm not getting into details, but please be aware that the DSE is your prop. Your actually, it's not an asset for you. It's a at least complete. Okay, statutory auditor. Yeah, this is what I said. The only place where the cost auditor fines are mentioned is section 143, subsection 12. Okay. Now let's just quickly roll over fraud area. Now, what is a liability for? I mean, you spoke for 1 hour, but you have still not told me why I am liable for. You will be liable for only two things. One, if you are negligent. That is, if you have done something with a free mind, knowing, unknowing, you did it. Negligence. Second one is mens rea. That is with a guilty mind. Now, the second one is what you cannot escape. The second one is what you will be imprisoned. The second one is where you will be prosecuted. Liability for negligence, the auditor is expected to perform duties and all that. So I just listed out, this is from one of your materials only, so there is nothing big about it. Consequences are compensatory and special. Compensatory is money terms and special is beyond the money, which is this fine and imprisonment, fine or imprisonment, all this stuff is available. And mitigation. I told you, I'll just bring you to this because this is the most important. You're slowly getting out of the chakra, you know. I brought you in. I'm trying to take you out. Very simple. Any mistake that you have done, first thing you should do is follow the feet. Say sorry. How do you say sorry? So what is your confession box? For a professional, what is the confession box? Okay, and then? Compounding. The other one is? Condoning. Let's go step by step. Companies Act has come out with lovely stuff for you. So, understand this. The sequence is very clear. First, pay the fee, pay the additional fee, compound, condone, adjudicate. I'm going to spend some time on that adjudication. Pay the penalty. Don't dispute. There are some people who, after the adjudication, will go and file a case against the ROC. Now, all that will not take you anywhere. Certain things, there are some solutions, not all are solution. Now, to answer that question, try not to pay a fine. Why? Because this is the difference between a penalty and a fine. Clear? So fine is what you go through a court process and pay. Penalty is what you go through a adjudication process. What is adjudication? Very simple. I'll just give you my most popular example. There was a company which was prosecuted for, you know what? Explanatory statement. All of you know what is that? No? Yeah. So basically, the board passes motion. Board passes resolution. Motion, resolution, everything is the same. So, and then shareholders approve this resolution. If it is a special resolution, the law says explanatory statement has to be there. Now, in your lifetime, have you taken a ruler, means scale, and measure the resolution, how big it is? No. Have you measured the explanatory statement, how big it is? So in this case, the logic is very simple. I took the ruler and checked. Resolution was 6 inches long. Or in fact 8 inches long. Explanatory statement was 4 inches long. What is the problem? Is it a problem? What funny, I mean, we were only told to draft resolutions. This guy is stretching as max. Any problem? Yeah. The problem is, the prosecution note is read like this. Your explanatory statement has to be bigger than the resolution. Serious. Now, what happened? Okay, if it has to be so funny, what happened? The resolution was self-explanatory. It was a detailed resolution. Okay? So what the company did, explanatory statement requires only 3 things. Interested party and none of the directors were interested, and then facts of this thing and one more, and then they packed it in about 4 lines, thinking that resolution is fully explained, so no need for a explanatory statement. Section 103 requires you to provide an explanatory statement. Now the contention was, your explanation was not bigger than the resolution. Any idea, penalty? There was one company and 6 directors. Penalty for the explanatory statement being 3 inches shorter is, 2 inches shorter is 3.5 lakhs. So, from Monday, all the resolutions take a ruler also, okay? Just see, this is big because this is not funny, this is a real-time case. So what happened? You have to pay up, right? I mean, when you are in front of an authority, you have to pay it up. Here, what the company did is, just go up here, say sorry, ROC is convinced, okay. Not convinced, they'll say no, you please pay up this, because when you plead enough, the penalty will still be only 3.5 lakhs. You know why? Because the section says, minimum penalty is 50,000 to 5 lakhs. So with great consideration for the 2 inches, I have to levy 3.5 lakhs. I can't go below that. Solution doesn't end there, don't worry. So you need to go to the RA's office and make a full explanation. If then somebody is considerate out there, then your petition will be admitted. That is, the order will be dismissed, right? So the first thing that you need to do for anything is today it's all come. Even if it is going to be one day delay for accounts, ROC will get a pong, reminder saying that this company has filed the financials only today, straight away prosecute them under 137. So sitting in his office, he can send you a show cause notice. You have to go and do the show there and request, ask minimum. So adjudication is the first solution. Second solution is the compounding, and the third one comes to condemnation. Okay, condemnation only certain things you can do, compounding certain things you can do, but this is the way you have to mitigate your tangible liability. Clear? Now when we get on to the reversal, what to reverse? Now this is what is a big issue, right? Now look, I have just done it. Very simple. Tangible liability, intangible liability. I'm trying to sum it up. Very simple. Tangible liability is for action. Intangible liability is for inaction. Okay? Inaction not because of you. Maybe somebody's action, but your inaction. Most important is a tangible liability arises because of matter of fact. An intangible liability arises because of matter of opinion. Now here I read this from Swaminathan Ankleshwar, an amazing economist. What is profit? Is it real? No, profit, is it real? No, I'm not talking about the fudged profit or not. Profit, is it real? No.
Purchase something
in
your
soul,
the difference is a profit.
Yeah. Is it real?
But it is a part of sale.
So, one thing which is you are offering up a lot of other questions which we are finding difficult to answer.
See, when you say profit is real, for me, it could mean cash profit. Cash is king at the end of the day. I add back the depreciation, I have something in cash, if I magic my bank balance, and I say it is real.
Good.
Is there profit?
I'll tell you, what I learned from that article is, loss is real, profit is not real. Loss is a matter of fact, profit is a matter of opinion. Same thing, liability is a matter of fact, asset is a matter of opinion. Clear? Yeah? I'm trying to think from a different aspect. So now, coming back to this, now understand that it is a matter of fact. Only one thing can happen, or multiple, which is known. Which is, you know the fact, you know the consequence. Very simple. In an intangible, unknown are the facts, unknown are the consequences. So actually you are entering a black hole when it is a liability. Going back to the Ambani story, when it was so funny saying, Ambani is trying to repay his liability with another liability. That is what is matter of fact. Whereas we all thought it is an asset. It is not an asset, it's a liability. Okay, so these are some of the analysis. And again, going back to my original slide, I started with the monkeys, I'm ending with the monkeys. I started with I am, who am I, and all that, so I'm closing it with that. Now understand, there are only three concepts, A, B, C. A is for abuse, B is for bias, C is for conflict. My general gyan to anybody is, any problem that you take in life will fall under only this category. There is no fourth category at all. Either it should fall under abuse, or it should be a biased decision, or there should have been a conflict in the decision. Right? Going by that, I am who? This was the second stage, or the first stage, sorry. And bias of position. Whenever there is a bias of position, you actually get to know the material ethical lapses. The ethical lapse, like somebody comes and confesses to you, comes under bias. So when he said, I have to think whether that is right or wrong, is a bias. That can be an unconscious bias, conscious bias, but it's a bias. Next one is, who am, is the power equation, abuse of power. That is where comes information asymmetry. What is information asymmetry? how much I should tell you, who decides? The person with power decides. And the last one is, who am I? Conflict, which is the Chanda ICSA case, where the board act, unfortunately, the risk of discovery happens after the person confesses about the conflict and not before. Okay, now, how to reverse? Be conscious of what you do. Use conscience to do what you do. Do not delegate your role and responsibility. The most important thing in an intangible liability is delegation. The moment you delegate, you don't know where your liability is. And you know, there was one point which I raised, I'll come to that. Okay, so from this yantra, mantra, tantra, what idea did you find applicable today? It is not look before you leave, it is look before you sign. Think before you sign, look before you sign. Was there one takeaway? Very simple, prevention is better than business. Which is not doing is better, but if you are doing, be careful. It's all about prevention. And third one is, take control of your signature, whether it is DSC or physical signature. Who drives your legal destiny? Only you drive. There is nobody else who can drive your legal destiny when it comes to an intangible liability. Tangible liability, 100% you. Intangible liabilities also looks like it's you. Okay? And look at this. Again, all these are my jugada. I just pull it up. Play your role or prepare for parole. Care for responsibilities or get scarred for irresponsibility. Exercise your right or perform your... I wanted to put last rights actually. Then I said, okay, last rights. Okay. Do your duty or pay a heavy duty. Nail the process or process away, which is very important that you need paper, 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 evidence. And empower the power or be overpowered. And last one is cover your liability or liability will sequel, Dabang 2. I'll see you soon. This is what you are raised. Correct? By mistake it came out. I thought nobody will touch this. This is a $1 billion question, right? Forget the balance sheet. In our life, how many of us can predict this contingent liability? There I would like to submit, sir, the spirit and the atma. So, Abdul Kalam collapsed like this, right? Speaking somewhere. So, I don't know whether what I am, who is speaking, but I have done justice in trying to deliver my session. Thank you all for a very patient listening. Any questions, please shoot.
Sir, one point you just said conclude.
Yeah.
Whatever you say, if you summarize, it's our destiny.
Yes. Very much. So, understand as a professional, if your life is eventless, you have to celebrate.
I'll give you a story about that. One person being stopped by his astrologer, he will die in a car accident. Sorry, vehicle accident. After that, he started avoiding vehicle, going everywhere by walk. One day, while walking on the road, car hit, he died.
So thank you all for a patient listening and hope to see you soon. Thank you.
I think this is the only presentation where I saw all the smiles, and throughout the session all the audience was very active. And I never knew there were so many meanings of spirits in the subject also actually. And he was very well present in tangible and intangible liability in real spirit of it. And it was a super merger of spirituality in our subjects. So let's give a big shout of clap to me. He deserves it more. Now I request the chairman of the branch, Shri Robert sir, to come forward and present a gift to watch as a token of gratitude. Please give a big round of applause. We wish his session continued after lunch also, but we'll have more of him in future programs. So let's go together, have lunch and come back after half an hour.